And I thank you. I just thank you for this opportunity to talk about the goodness. Taking you to another level. Oh, God. First and foremost, I just want to honor my heavenly Father once again. Yes. Amen. Amen. Because without him, I would be standing before you.
Amen.
God is a good God.
Oh, yes.
And he is worthy to be praised.
Amen.
I want to thank God for my leaders, Bishop and Pastor Brown.
Amen.
I thank God. I thank God for all the clergy and all the brothers and the sisters, the mothers, and oh, God is good. This is just, I gotta say this, this truly is a church that's built on love. Built on love. And I thank you. I needed to uplift my Father today. First, let me pray. Heavenly Father, I just thank you for this opportunity today, Father God, to speak to your people, Father God. Father God, pour into this empty vessel on today, Father God. Touch the hearts and the minds of your people, Father God, so they'll be able to receive what I have for them, what you have for them. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
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 Thank you, God.
Amen. We'll all come to another level.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Do you believe it?
Thank you.
Do you receive it? And my topic would be, where is God taking you?
Amen. Amen.
I'll be coming from James 4 and 10. Humble yourself in the sight of the Lord, and he shall lift you up. May God have a blessing and the beauty of the world.
Amen.
What stand out to me in that scripture was humble yourself.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
The word humble, it means showing submissive respect, not prideful, or arrogant. Now, to be a humble man, you have to be humble. So we know the devil, his pride is one of the things that took him to hell.
That's right. Amen.
You know, when I think about humble, I think about people. I thought about one of the things the bishop said to me one day. He said, Dick, I want you to speak at a deacon service. I looked around and said, why me? He said, and I'm out just for the Lord. I'm just sold out. So when he called me to do something, you know, I'm a little stubborn because my flesh is not willing. But my spirit said yes.
Amen.
And we all should want to do the work of the Lord.
Amen.
How can you know when the Lord is taking you to another level? When I see a change in people, you know, I was telling Sean the other day, I said, wow. I see your growth. I said, you're really, really growing. See, God will change your mind, your heart. You have a passion to do His will. You don't mind committing yourself. Sometimes we come in here early in the morning,
that's right.
Humbling, isn't it?
That's right.
God's been good to us.
Amen.
And it's not about us. You know, when you love the Lord, you want to do His good will.
That's right.
Amen.
You want to love Him.
That's right.
And you must understand that it's not about done something for each and every one of you.
Yes.
So when it's time to put the work in, you must understand me. That's all part of another level. You know, when I thought about another level, I went all different directions. I'm that guy in this room. I started thinking about salvation. Because it started with me. You know, I was low to the ground. I was busted up. I had no way to turn. So you know what I did? I went to another level. I said, God, have your way with me.
Amen.
Wherever you want me to go, I'll go. I'll follow you.
Amen.
I won't follow me.
Amen.
I'll follow you.
Amen.
And let me tell you, once I gave my life to Christ, things started to happen.
Yes.
This was a second.
Amen.
Every step that I took, I had to be so good. And for someone said, use me. You always have to let God lead you.
Amen.
Ask no question. Lean not to your own
understanding. Amen.
You went there with Cherry Hill. When I first got saved, it makes you want to do something.
Yeah.
I told my wife, I said, you know what? I'm going to be a usher.
Amen.
Gotta do something.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. Anybody knows, you got to work for you.
Yes.
I mean, that's why your kids, you got to get them a part of something. You know, that's keeping.
Amen.
But anyway, when he comes over to my house, and I said, now get me a black suit, a cane and cheese. Because I won't be a manager. Because I had to put my work in.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
Jesus. One cane and cheese, help some. I said, I told my wife, I said, this job is mine. I'm claiming this thing. So
good. Yes,
you know, they might be on the spot.
Amen.
Wow.
Amen.
God is good. Look at that. So you can use me.
Amen.
Start working. Man, but I was working for him. I was working for the world.
Right.
I started giving my testimony. I started glorifying God. I started leading people.
Amen.
Oh, God is good.
Amen.
Bless the Lord. Because it's all about doing the work.
Yes.
And giving the testimony.
Amen.
About where God brought you from.
Yes.
I know he brought me a mighty, mighty long way.
Amen.
Oh, God. You know, it's something when you start blessing certain saints and they start hearing. And you know what? It's going to be to start praising God. Oh, my God. Like this door, but God always has a way.
Yes.
If we was away from people that couldn't see it.
Yeah.
Hey, you got to get it out.
Yes.
You got to tell somebody. You want to work for the Lord.
Amen.
Taking me to him.
Amen.
Yes, yes, he is.
It didn't stop there. I'm telling my story.
Amen.
Work there. Then, Bishop came to me. Hey. God called me to meet you. Here I go. Another level.
Amen.
Not because I wanted it, but God. Because God used our leaders. We can't see what's in us. We can't see. God, your leader, he shows you.
Amen.
Don't ask me a question. I said, I know. You know, it's so awesome to know that if you believe and you hold on, you don't go back. Now I know some people even you know, say, well, I fell. Now I don't know if anybody knew my story, but I'm going to tell you. This is my personal moment.
Amen.
I I was an alcoholic for over 30 years. You know? And it took one day for me to come in and just surrender and say, God, have your way with me.
Amen.
God, help me.
Yes.
One day.
Amen.
Can somebody say one day?
One day.
I never look back.
Amen.
Never look back.
Because
God's been good. He is good.
Amen.
He knows. Like I said, He knows the beginning and He knows the end.
Yes, He
does. And it was so funny. Came in, I was praising, I was dancing, had my jacket swinging. My wife was so embarrassed. I was dancing. See, it was all part of God's plan. She didn't know. I was dancing. You know, when I was out there, I used to dance and cut up and do all these things. It's all a part of God's plan.
Amen.
I'm sorry, Pastor. So, I got to give you my story.
Yeah.
But we came to be what you say. So I started dancing for the Lord.
Oh.
Ain't good?
Yes,
if I dance out in the world,
right.
Fuck it, you dance for me.
Right.
I'm dancing like David.
Right.
So I was set up.
Yes,
so we start dancing and glorifying God. And the Lord started going. Oh, it's a
nice.
We danced on television, and we were talking to the host, we were just talking in general about these things. We thought we were kids. We thought we were
kids.
I'm 56 years old.
Amen.
I said, what? Amen. Now remember, let's go back. I was an alcoholic for 30 years.
Yes.
No scars.
Uh-huh. Yes.
No. Been drinking that long, but even though they don't drink, they got a drunk book about them, you know, and they all drunk
about
them.
Amen.
Remember, they
don't
know.
That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
I don't know if you know about that,
but
I know. Matter of fact, I'll be 57 and 87. I'm moving right along by His grace and His mercy.
Yeah.
He did this. So the host now, we began to talk. I was getting sick. He said, wait a minute, you gotta get this on air. So I gave my testimony over the air.
That's right.
God has a way of setting things up.
Yeah.
He has a way.
Yeah.
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 It wasn't for my glory. It was for His glory.
Yeah.
His glory. And to say, somebody needed to hear this. If He did it for me, He can do it for
me. Amen. Yes.
Amen. Right.
Amen.
But I tell you, my walk with God has been so awesome. And everybody, I don't know, we're going to Grammys, y'all.
Amen.
You know what they call that? Thank you.
Amen.
When you live right, and you stay humble, you got to stay humble.
Right.
You know, our bishop, he's humble.
Amen.
Our pastor, she's humble.
Amen.
You know, Minister Tony, I had an opportunity to meet your pastor one day. He said, anyway. And it's been come candy for it too. So I met him, we were talking. I didn't know who he was. I talked to everybody. You know, because that's why God set me up. I didn't know he was a man. You know, he's talking the goodness of God and God's been good to me. He never said he was a man. He was humble. You know? love humble people.
Amen.
They're great people. When they're arrogant, you know, I speak of arrogant. Ministers, oh, they think they just all that. I can feel the spirit. I can discern, you know? No, the devil knows the word.
Yeah,
they matter.
Don't he?
Amen. I mean, they would speak, they're giving me scripture after scripture. But then I'm watching them. I'm trying to steal something. But they're giving me word, prophesying to me, everything. I'm like, oh my God, you know? But you know, I'm going someplace else. Oh my God. You know, when you have great leaders, and not just speak the word of God,
amen.
Oh my God, what an awesome thing. I'm blessing God, my leaders.
Amen.
And speak the word of God. Awesome, awesome. Can you please give them a hand? My daughter's 16. She understands.
Amen.
I mean, sometimes when you least expect it, she'll break it down. So that's when you know you got a great leader. Because the word shouldn't be so complicated. It should be easy to find it to understand. Because the word is good.
Amen.
It's a way of living. You know? But I'm going to leave you with this. Make you perfect. I'm from Hebrews 13 and 21. Make you perfect in every good work to do His will. Working in you that which is well pleasing in His sight. May you have God bless me, keep me strong, and taking me to another
level. Amen.
Amen. Amen.